Hello students and friends, in this video we are going to see a demo on AFM analysis using the software called Quaidon. Once again, it is also a openware to analyze the SPM images, and here in this demo we are going to analyze only the AFM image, how you can process the data, how you can get the three-dimensional view of that particular image, and what are the statistical parameters you can get out of it. So all these things we are going to see in this particular demo. For that, first you have to open this particular software, Quaidon. So once you open this particular software, here first thing what you have to do is you have to go for color gradients, and you have to select the gold as a default color. Okay, so you just put a tick mark in front of gold and you just press this star button so that the selected gold color will be set as a default color for all the opened images. Okay, so otherwise the images will be in grayscale. So I insist you to select this particular gold color as a default color. Okay, so next you just go to file and open the file whatever you want, that is your AFM image. Okay, maybe for this image I am going to do all the analysis. Sorry, maybe not for this, maybe I'll take this one. Okay, you just take this as an example. First thing is we have to process the data. Sometimes if you see this as a 3D view, sometimes the data will not be in a plane. Sometimes it will be some hump like stuff, structure will be there, background structure of that image. Sometimes it will be some slope like structures will be there for the data. So you have to correct the background here once again. So to do that, you just press this particular icon, align rows using various methods. So if you press this method, first you can select any of the methods to correct the background. So maybe I'm taking the polynomial function, and first I have this is the matching, and this is modus and median and differences, and this one is median. Like that you can have different methods. I'm taking the polynomial as a method, so you can increase or decrease the polynomial order. And after doing it for horizontal, I have to do it for vertical also. Now you just see, for the vertical also I am doing all those things. So after, if you do the polynomial correction of the background, you just see the exact background will be at exactly at dark in color, and the peak will be in very contrast in color. Okay, so like that you have to do the background alignment using the polynomial functions or any of the methods available here. After that you just press OK. Now this is a polynomial corrected background corrected image. Now here you just see the background is exactly dark, and it is here it is exactly the white in color, right? But the background should be start from zero. Okay, for that what you have to do is you have to shift the data. You are not correcting the data, only you are shifting the data to zero. Okay, so it is not coming under the image manipulation and all, only we are going to shift the data to zero. Okay, for that what you have to do is you have to go to here you have to go to shift minimum data value to zero, right? If you press that, right now here it is -65.6, right? If you press that, you just see now here it is 0 to 136. Earlier it was -65 to 70, like that, but the overall height of the data remains constant, but only the minimum value is shifted to zero. Okay, so after that what we have to do is, if you want to see the process is over, so if you want to so many processes are available in this software, but they are all not allowable for publication. Okay, so if you do so, it means that you are manipulating the data. But we are not supposed to manipulate the data. Only this is what thing we can do it for this particular AFM data. Okay, so if you want to see the image in 3D view, just simply press display a 3D view of data. So you can have a 3D image, so you can play around with the image of your need, and you can save it from here. One save button is there. You can save it from there, wherever you want. You can save it, okay, by giving one name. You can save it, okay, that's it. And here, if you want to save this particular 2D image, just go to file and press save as. And you can have any name, so you can have a TIFF format for your publications. So press save button. After that, it will ask you for some information, whether you want to save the image with the scale inside or outside scale, like that. It will ask some option to you. So for that, you just go to lateral scale. So if you want to have rulers in the outside, or you want to have it as a scale bar, you can select the different options here, like that. Okay, and one more thing is, so if you want to have a tick mark here, you can select this. Draw label means if you want to have the date, the value of that particular scale bar, you can have it. And this option above or below the text, that also can be taken here. So like that, you can have the control of all the parameters. And here again, so if you want to have that particular EZ scale, you can have it. Otherwise, you can disable that for your wish. So for that, I want to have it here. Maybe you can manipulate all those things. So here you just see, you can that is a precision. So you can have a title for this also. So like that you can have whatever you want, right? So after that, you just simply press OK. The 2D data also will be saved, and after that 2D image of the data will be saved. After that, if you want to extract the statistical quantities out of this particular AFM image, you just simply press statistical quantities, and here you just see you can have all the values, means average value and RMS roughness and grain wise roughness, mean roughness, skewness value of that data, and kurtosis values of the data. So all the statistical parameter of the data will be available for you. And here you just see the projected data is 1x1, right? The data data is 1 micron x 1 micron, so that it should be 1 micrometer square. But you just see now, because of the nano structures present in the surface, the exact area, the 1 micrometer square, is increased to 1.3 micrometer square, right? So here the surface area is increased since we are having nano structures in the topography. Okay, so if you want to save this particular data to text file, you can save it. So here you just see 1D data, 3D data, all the data are available. So if you want to save the statistical data, you can save it. Otherwise, if you want to copy it, you can copy it, and you can paste it in anywhere else. Okay, so that's it. I hope this video will be helpful to all of you.